When I get a DCIS score back, obviously I'm always hoping that it's low, just as I hope that all my Oncotype scores are low on my patients. I take a look at it and come up with basically what I think is the recommendation that will be best for the patient. We function in a multidisciplinary conference that prospectively evaluates 100% of our patients, so that I also know that I have to come up with something that is going to be accepted by the remainder of the team, the oncologist, the radiation oncologist, and the other members of the conference committee. When I meet with a patient, I share with her the actual report form, in which the graphics are well done. It allows her to look at the recurrence score itself. It allows us to look together at the risk of having something come back in that breast. And then we look at the risk of developing an invasive breast cancer in that breast. So I go through the entire process directly with the patient. That helps begin the dialogue, because after all, everything is a dialogue. You have to actually talk to the patient, explain things to the patient. For the ease of it, most patients would like to avoid radiation therapy. Obviously, in young women, 33 daily treatments of radiation over 7 weeks is something that they just really would rather not have. So it's a tool that makes it very comfortable and easy to talk to the patient, explain what it's about. I'm very comfortable explaining the biology of a recurrence score, how the genes are identified, and what we're looking at. So it's a helpful form.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.